Discoverer aims to radically redesign Earth observation satellites for sustained operation at significantly lower altitudes, effectively getting closer to the things that we image. This means that the satellites can produce not only higher resolution imagery, but the payloads can be both smaller and lighter. We're looking at very low Earth orbits, which can be defined as orbits which are significantly affected by atmospheric drag. So the atmospheric drag significantly affects the design of the satellite itself. This is typically from the Kármán line at 100 kilometers altitude all the way through to about 450 kilometers altitude just above the International Space Station. Traditional satellites fly at higher altitudes to avoid atmospheric drag almost entirely, at say 600 to 800 kilometers. But by flying lower, that key benefit that we get is a reduction in the size of the satellite and therefore its cost, and consequently a reduction in the cost of the Earth observation data that we get from those satellites. We're developing new technologies for aerodynamic satellites which operate in an entirely new orbital regime, a regime that's been typically avoided because of the difficulties of working there, despite the many benefits of doing so. And if successful, these technologies will completely change the way that we obtain satellite-based Earth observation data. And it's not only Earth observation that's affected as well, it's also communications and broadband satellites which will be improved. Effectively, we can reduce that return time for signals from the satellite to ground-based users.
Markets with big demand of very high resolution as defense, infrastructure, location-based service or disaster management could benefit from these assets. In particular, we see a major potential in terms of demand from infrastructure for value-added services, for instance, the monitoring of civil engineering projects or location-based service, for instance, the monitoring in real time of traffic. So reducing the cost of the way we are getting this imagery will have an impact throughout the value chain.
Well, we're developing a facility to replicate the aerodynamic flow around satellites in very low Earth orbits, so we can test new aerodynamic materials. And that facility should be operational by early 2019. We'll be validating the performance of those materials as well as new aerodynamic control concepts on a small satellite which should be launching in early 2020. And we'll be doing ground-based demonstrations of atmosphere-breathing electric propulsion.
We are testing in this facility, which is a facility for electric propulsion systems, an inductively heated plasma generator called IPG6S. This plasma source is quasi the forefather of the planned inductively heated plasma thruster in Discoverer. We do that in order to learn the interactive behavior and operational behavior of the plasma source and the power unit, which creates a database for the later design of the inductively heated plasma thruster in Discoverer. In addition, we can use this experience in order to qualify the needed measurement techniques and the test procedures. The relevant technologies will be developed within Discoverer. And so far we have looked at one subsystem, which is called the propellant collector, which is an intake that collects gas particles at the high altitudes. So for example, in very low Earth orbit. This was done by a modeling approach where we simulated existing intakes successfully. In addition, we are looking at a thruster concept, which is based on an electromagnetic principle. This leads to the fact that the thruster does not need to have it to be employed with electrodes, because the electrodes would be the limiting factor in terms of lifetime as they interact chemically with the chemically aggressive particles in the very low Earth orbit.
Satellite-derived Earth observation data is already used for the benefit of the public in many areas. Data from very low Earth orbit satellites can be used for intelligence and security, for supporting our response to disasters, for maritime surveillance, for civil protection, and also for land management and precision agriculture. Our aim is to produce technologies which enable us to obtain this data at lower cost, while also placing the European industry at the forefront of this rapidly growing sector. And it's also an exciting opportunity for us to work with colleagues from across Europe to help develop the next generation of Earth observation satellites.